Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of Scrap Mechanics. And on tonight's episode, I am joined by a very good friend. We have Cypher Deck with us.
Hey everyone, this is Cypher Deck.
And we also have Silo on Wheels over here. He's not on the Skype call, but he is building something over here on the map with us. And we are going to be finishing the second half of the build for the forklift. Now, in between this episode and the last one, Cypher over here has done some things to the forklift. I'm going to let him explain exactly what he's done, and we'll check it out in great detail here.
So the first forklift that I made, it only had two options. It could go all the way up, or it could come all the way down. This time, I per AC's input, I went ahead and made it so it's two stages. So it should lift once, and then lift again to raise it even higher. And this will allow us to put it, put items on shelves, and then also pick them up from the bottom. And that's pretty much what we've done since then.
Now I'm going to remove a little bit of your housing in here so we can show the computer terminals and exactly what the programming is on that. So you have two of them in there, don't you, right?
Yep.
Okay, so the first one right here is set up to 45, 45, 105, and 105. And it's set to fast. Where's the second computer terminal? I only see one in there.
Oh, it's right in there.
Oh, right at the very front. Okay. And then yep. The first one is 45, 45, 90, 90, 45, and 45. Now, which one of these computer terminals operates which of these conveyor belts over here? Is that first one?
The one closest to the seat is the one that controls the very first one.
Okay, so these are the ones at the very tip of the edge. Actually, no, it's the ones at the closest to the actual vehicle. Those are that are lifted up. And then the second one activates the tip of the edge one. So when you guys are setting this up, try to make sure that you do it the exact same way. It took us a little while to get it figured out. That's why we did it off camera, because there was a lot of trial and error to make sure that it went up straight and that the forklift pieces didn't move from their given position, because you don't want them to move from it. Granted, there are circles, so it could roll, and as long as the pallet that you were lifting up is big enough, you would be okay. But as it stands right now, if he lifts it up while I'm standing on here, I'll go with it, and I won't fall in between these things. So you can... Oh.
Yeah, you will. Only at the top.
Only at the top, okay. So it does move out just a tiny bit, apparently. Let me see if I can just stand on one. Go ahead, do it again.
Okay.
Let's see if, oh, that kind of pushed me off to the side. Do it again. Go. Oh, no.
Okay, let's try this. Let's go ahead and go with the front ones first, and then we'll go with the second ones.
Yeah, it spreads out.
It's pushing you off.
But, you know, if you come over here to one of the pallets that we've built. Oh, is it on run?
For some reason, it's moving without me asking it to. Okay. Oh, it's still doing it. Why is... I don't know why it was doing that.
Okay, I am going to detach it from the ground here, if I can get in there. Okay. I did build this little pallet. I built the one right next to it as well. Wow, it really doesn't want me to get in there, huh? Come on, let me do it. You can do it. There we go. Wow, it's a kind of a weird angle, and the computer just, or the game, just doesn't seem to want to let me do it very well. Okay, there we go. It's going to fall down in a second. As soon as we get it in there, there we go. A little bit more. There we go. Okay, so let me remove the front piece.
That's not the right block. I'm going to put pallet stoppers on the front of this. That way it doesn't go into the pallet itself.
Let me raise it up. Let me put it on a... Raise it up like that. That way you can get underneath it. Because I need to put... Actually, let me just raise it up and put a couple of... That way it's high enough.
It only needs to be one block high. It just... Or two blocks high, rather.
That's all right. Just give it a little bit extra.
Okay.
There you go. Now you should be able to lift that up. And if I'm standing right on top of this, he should lift me up with it. And then you can use this as a platform to kind of do things at a greater height. Let's see how this works.
Get the pallet stopper. There we go. And then we go slow enough.
Is that the highest it can go, or you can go even higher?
Oh, no, it can go higher.
Right. Let's see the highest it can go.
Oh, sorry. Did I drop it? Nope.
No, we're still on
still
it.
Still there.
So you can see this could be very, very useful to get around. And, of course, the sky is really the limit on how far this can go, depending on how big you want to make this machine, how many arms you want to attach to it, and how much ballast you want to put onto the back. Again, if you find the right spot, you could always attach that pallet to the ground itself. And once that's attached to the ground, it's not going anywhere. So this pallet could go up as high or be as heavy as you want it to be. Let's see if he can do it, if he can raise it up. No, he can't raise that one up because that one is still attached to the ground. So let's see if we can remove that form so it's not attached anymore. Only need to remove a few pieces here and there. There we go. Come on, let me do it. So much grass over here, I think that's what's getting in the way. Almost one more piece. There we go. Now he should be able to do it. Oh, not quite. Not quite. his arms just aren't far enough. You know, they're not long enough, I should say, to be able to do it.
But the body is made out of all metal, so he should be able to lift it better than I can for right now until I put all the ballast on it.
Right. Let me raise that up. I'll put a couple more legs on it to give each of you a little bit easier chance to do that. There we go. One more. Nice. And of course, you know, that build is not done just yet. We're just kind of showing you the preliminary of what it can do and what it looks like. We do need to put more ballast over here on the back, and we're going to show you exactly what we've done with that here in a bit. But oh, yeah, look at that. You're lifting up some heavy weight right there, too.
Yep.
And I put a little bit of everything on there, you guys. The ice blocks, the nice marble flooring. I put some concrete in there.
It is tipping forward whenever I stop, if you see it.
Yeah, but you're not done with the ballast in the back, though. So once you put that there, I think you're going to be more than fine with lifting something like this.
Oh.
Let me get that other piece out of your way.
No, I was actually trying to put it on top of that.
Oh, I think he's going to go for it. Let's see if he picks it up.
Okay.
Okay, so yeah, he's able to slide underneath it. And his is really low to the ground, too. So look at that. That's actually pretty cool.
Am I stuck in? Oh, there we go.
Oh, yeah, see, so he made his longer as well. Oh, nope, didn't quite do it. Let me see, can I lift that up? Let's put that over here out of the way so he can get in there if he needs to. And we'll have to test out just how much weight that thing can lift. We'll build a couple more pallets. I wish there was a copy and paste one so we could just do that, but we'll build a couple more pallets and we'll put it with some of the heaviest material we can possibly get to see how that works. In fact, one thing that Cypher was saying that we could try is putting some of these baskets of food on there just to see what that would look like. Let me go ahead and add some of that on there.
Oops.
And I don't think they're the same size. I think one's a little bit bigger than the other, to be honest. So I don't know if they're going to fit on top of each other. The smaller one definitely fits on top of the bigger one, but the other way around.
Oops, I'm stuck.
Okay, let me write these things back. There we go.
I have to believe that there has to be a way to make this a springboard.
What do you mean by a springboard?
Well, just watch. If I do... It just feels like you'd be able to make a springboard out of that.
Oh, maybe. I don't know. I mean, we'll have to mess around with that a little bit. But in the meantime, I guess we can go ahead and finish the build and try some different stuff out. Oh, it's crashed.
Yep, it did.
Ah, dang it. It crashed again, guys. All right, guys. Well, this is going to be a short video, apparently. In fact, maybe if I get back into it, it will restart the video. I don't know. Let me see if I load back into it, whether the game will pick up the video recording or not. If not, we'll just go ahead and end it here and yeah, show you guys the second or the third half of this, which is to put the body on, create a chair. We're going to actually raise the chair up a little bit so the center of gravity is a little bit higher, especially when you build these types of things. You want that to be as high as possible so that you have the best view as well. Yeah, and it loaded it back into it. So, okay, we can just keep going. Let's do that.
Okay, I'm loading back in now.
Now, the bugs in this game is because it's still in development. It's still early access on Steam. So you just kind of had to expect that these things are going to happen from time to time. Just, you know, it's not really that big of a deal. We don't get too many of them happen. And when they do happen, it's very easy to get back into the game very quickly. So you don't lose anything. Thankfully, you know, the programmers have realized that you may be kicked out of the game at any time. And I think it saves, like, constantly. Because any work that we've ever done, whether it was something I just put down and then it crashed, is always right there when I come back. So I'm kind of glad about that. I've been in games where when it crashes, you lose hours of work, sometimes
it
even more than that.
It just crashed. Oh, never mind. It's good.
Okay, all so right. You are using what kind of material on the back of this? This is steel, right? The metal?
It's metal, yeah. And I'm gonna go ahead and load that up, and then also put the chair up higher, which means I'm going to have to rewire some of it, not all of it.
But at least you know it works, and all you have to do is rewire it back together, and it should be just fine. So you can see he did, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 blocks going straight back. And on the bottom, he did 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 blocks here and 14 blocks on the top. And it goes up 1, 2, 3 high for that first part. And then for the second part, it goes in one. And goes up another 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 blocks. So you can do that on both sides. Now you're going to want this to be completely filled in with metal, right?
Yes.
It's going to be one solid brick. And that is so that you can lift up the really, really heavy pieces over here on the front. It's the ballast that you absolutely have to have. Now this is the heaviest material in the game, or no?
I believe so, because even with all this ballast... You can't lift it. Can't lift a pallet of just this stuff.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's the only material I didn't put on my little crate over there, so that we will have to try that. We might be able to get away with it. Again, another technique to do would be to actually connect it to the ground somehow. Like, let me go back to the wood, and we'll go this way. Yeah, this is the way I want to go. So what I could do is I could raise it up and then connect it over in this fashion. Bring it down as soon as he moves. There you go. And now it's connected to the ground, so no matter what happens, if it tries to tip over, it's going to hit that bar. And if that bar was directly over it, it wouldn't go anywhere. It would just kind of get stuck on that. So you fill that in completely right there.
Yep.
Now you're leaving a little indentation here on the top, or no?
Yeah, actually, should go ahead and fill this in.
And you left one in the back as well.
Yeah, that, I'm going to sculpt these so it just has a...
Oh, a certain look to it?
Yeah, so it doesn't just look like a solid hunk of metal.
Right.
So I'll go ahead and remove two layers down here, and then move one layer there. And I left the sides open so you can see the motors. This way you can actually control them, change the speed, because once you have all this weight on it, you are going to want to up the speed a lot.
Right. And the chair right behind the chair is the access port to your computer, so maybe put maybe put a space back there so you can actually get back there from where your chair is. You can move the chair up slightly.
Yeah, the chair is moving up to where the wheels are. This way we can make sure that it has the ability to access that. I'm actually going to put doors in front of that, so those will slide up and be able to see those.
Okay, so let's see. What's your next step? You're going to move the chair first, or you're going to put the platform, the flooring down for the chair?
I'm going to put the chair next, And I'm just trying to see what material I want to use. Probably something light, even though I'm going to be putting metal around it at some point. So let's see, something like this. I think it is 6 long.
You're doing 6 long, starting with 1 square.
And then 4 wide. Yep.
Okay, so that goes all the way to that. Oh, and you got rid of the chair.
Oh, I did not mean to do that.
Let me see if I can stop it.
Put it on a lift. Lift, lift. Oh my goodness. That thing is moving. It's booking.
There we go. 5th time.
Oh, that's his. I'm looking at his. I was like, wow, that thing is really moving.
Oh yeah, his is pretty good, man. I like his design. It doesn't go up quite as far or as high as yours does. But, you know, that was like kind of your first design right there, is just go up once.
Yep. All right, so we'll go over 4. And I'm thinking we'll go up 6. So 6x4x6.
Now, the reason for going lightweight is what?
Because
because you would think that you know, no matter where the weight is distributed on this platform, it would still help out lifting up the heavy objects that come out so far, especially if you extend this arm to go out even more than it already is. You could go, you know, several layers out this way, and then this entire thing back over here would be the ballast.
Actually, I'm putting ballast right here.
Okay, so you're going to put ballast in the front anyways.
Yeah. Actually, I can go ahead and put more in between, but I don't want the whole thing to...
So you want the metal to go on both sides all the way out? So you want this layer right here filled up, going up like that?
I'm sorry?
This little piece right here wasn't here. Did you want that as a layer as well?
No, yeah, you could put that as a layer, and then we'll round the tops whenever we figure out how high we're going to take it.
Okay.
But these will go up 1, 2, 3. That's probably high enough.
For the chair?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think so. That's actually a pretty good view right there. Of course, you know, the higher up you went with that chair, the bigger the ballast could be over here on the back, so.
Yeah. Plus, I still have my my roof plan I'm going to do.
I don't know if that looks like a tongue sticking out or not.
What? Yeah,
not really. On the side of your vehicle, there's a happy face. So this design I actually really like, because we've built a few things like the roller coasters, and when you're building the platforms for the roller coasters, the actual tracks to lay, they go up pretty high, and it's kind of annoying to have to build a ramp every single time you want to get up there, and then you have to run the track all the way over to where you're building it, and if you fall off, you got to go all the way back, run back up, and stuff like that. So this can move with you, and as long as it doesn't exceed the height of... you know, how high this can go, it's going to be used as a mobile platform. Now, for some of you, yeah, you may never even use anything like that, but for us, it's going to come really, really handy to be able to do it. So, just kind of wish it was on that world. I hope at some point they do initiate the ability to cut and paste items from one... and there we go, we got another crash.
Yeah.
It seems like anytime we all get close to one another, and we're all doing something, that's when it really crashes on us. So... if you're playing multiplayer, if you're spread out, and we've done this for hours, I'm talking like 16, 17 hours on a roller coaster world where we're all doing something different. And it worked just fine. We're all in different parts of the map. We're all working on something separate, and we never had any crashes. But when you have almost nothing on the map except a few items, and you're all still next to one another, that's when this thing crashes constantly. So... just one of those things you got to be aware of and maybe try to avoid being in the general vicinity. For me, though, I'm not really doing anything other than recording what's going on at the moment. Oh, it's taking off again. Let me put it back. Yeah, because there's no driver's seat. There we go.
I was putting driver's seat at least.
Yeah, I think you put it on, then you put it backwards, and you were taking it off to put it back on the right way, so.
Yeah.
Right. Silo's thing is still moving around a little bit. Oh, it's the arms trying to right themselves, and it's kind of stuck in the thing there. It's kind of funny. Let me see if I can help him out. Get this out of the way. There we go. What are these on the end of them? I don't know what that is. Oh, that's kind of a cool idea. I'll have to show you that when you get back. He put these little corner pieces, the little round pipe pieces on the end. And I don't know if he put a bearing in there, but if you did, you could have it where you could turn that at the last minute and lock the pallet in place.
Yeah.
So that's kind of a neat little thing to do. That way it wouldn't fall off the edge if you're going really, really fast. Although the pallet itself would have to be the right size for it to fit in there real snug. But definitely something you could try doing on that one. And then hit that button again, it will lower it so you could slide it off if you needed to.
Well, there's a way to, I think whenever I was using the other blocks that I was using, it required the pallet to have a slot that was too wide for each one of those bars. With these, it only requires one slot, so you could actually have two slots for that hook.
Yeah, it's definitely something we can play around with a little bit and just try out to see how they work. I don't know if I like that right there. Let's get rid of some of these. Now we can put down another one. Okay, so we got some grass pallets on there. That's kind of cool looking. Let's add another layer so it looks like it fits in there just fine. There you go. And we'll fit some other stuff on here while we wait for them to get back. Some flowers, potted vine plants. Let's try that. Oh yeah, so they're nice and big. Add some variation to it. There we go. What else do we got in here? Small potted plants. We'll throw some of those on there. Are you back?
I am back.
There. Now that looks like something you might actually move around. Okay, so you're adding the seat on there. Now you're not going to make this solid underneath, right?
I am. I was going to use, actually, is that all the way forward? It is, yep. I was going to fill it in with metal.
Oh, okay. So you're going to give that extra strength to it, that extra weight.
Yep.
Now, as far as I know, objects in this game cannot be destroyed. So it's not like they really have strength to any of the blocks that we're putting down just yet. I would like to see that become a thing, though, because it would be very, very cool to create a bulldozer-type bot that will help you destroy blocks that have been put on the ground that you're no longer using anymore. Because they do add a fair bit of lag, and accidents happen. And until they put that undo button in there, I'm just, you know, just throwing an idea out there, guys. Please put the undo button in. Until they do that, you're going to have some accidents happen, and you're going to have pieces, sometimes large amounts of pieces left that you have to go back and destroy. When we lost our roller coaster that I had spent about 8 hours on, completely, building, it took about another 2 hours to, you know, disassemble all the pieces from that track and just get rid of the lag that it was causing. So if you had a vehicle that could go through it, it would have saved a lot of time. And it would have been kind of cool because it would be more, you know, actual construction type. Let me go in there and, you know, bulldoze it and, you know, put it all into one spot and maybe even have a bulldozer type vehicle that can pick the stuff up and drop it into a machine that I made that will, you know, disassemble the parts itself. So, you know, I mean, if they want to make it where it's more creative and less destructive, that's fine with me too. Just give me the ability to create something that is somewhat destructive in nature so I can get rid of those parts in a very creative way, you know, like almost in real life way kind of way.
Yep.
Okay, so you're adding some round pieces onto that. Let me see, what piece is that? That is your duck corner, okay. And it's lightweight on that one.
Oh yeah, super white, super light. And it works perfectly. And so now I'm going to go ahead and connect everything back up, which should be very easily done. All we have to do is connect to the engines, which there's four of them.
Okay, let me go ahead and round these pieces off for you in the back.
Go ahead and, before you do that, go ahead and take, let's see, take one more, two more layers off the bottom one, one layer off the next one.
Two more layers off the bottom one?
Mm-hmm. That way it just doesn't look really weird and rounded. That way it has a little...
There we go. And one more layer off the top one?
And one layer off the top one, yeah.
There we go.
Yep. And then when you put the rounded in, it has a space, and it doesn't make it look like it's going up a rounded roller coaster.
Right. It's going to take off a little bit of the weight, but like I said, that's not too big of a deal. Should still have
we'll add it.
Enough.
Yeah, we'll add it back on at some point. All right. Next is connecting the wheels in the back here.
So you're just reconnecting what you already had.
Yep. So everything should run pretty easily, or it should reconnect pretty easily, rather. I hope that's one.
And I'm just adding some looks to it, guys. Some basic looks just for design purposes, and see how it works out.
All right, and I'm gonna go ahead and clear my bar because I have too much stuff on it. I really wish whenever you go into a world that you've already been into, like if you're grouping with friends, that you kept what was on your bar instead of having to reload it every time.
Well, you know, like I said, it is still in development, so they're going to be making some changes to it as time goes on. That might be one of the things that they add into it. We'll just have to see how that works out. I don't know if that looks all right or not. Let me bring that back down. We'll try something else. Different color, maybe.
And then...
Let's see, what can we add there? Maybe yellow? No. Everything's going to be too big, I think.
Maybe is it me or is it lagging?
No, it's not lagging on mine, not yet.
Okay. It just got really lagging for some reason. Oh, now it's not.
There we go. Can we get it in there? There. Still doesn't quite meet up with it. Like, it's off by like half an inch. You see that? On these pipes, on these tubes? Like, it doesn't really fit on the bottom piece.
No, it doesn't.
For some reason. Like, it's sitting on there, but it just doesn't line up.
What if you use,
I have the small ones I put on there, too, but that one doesn't seem to work either.
Hmm.
See, but they do stack on top of each other just fine. Those stack up nice. It just won't stack on that bottom piece. Yeah, I don't know on that one, guys. We'll have to mess around and see what we can figure out.
You put a smiley face on the side of my vehicle? That's what?
It wasn't me. That was somebody else, man.
Mm-hmm. All right.
There we go.
See how it is.
That kind of lines up a little bit. It's not too bad. Doesn't really line up with the color, but, you know. Let's see, can we get that on there? Yes, we can. And again, this is going to add ballast to the overall design, but more than that, it adds kind of a look to it. Let's see, what can we run through on the back? Maybe something like... Oh, you know what? They actually have a steel palette. I haven't ever put that down. Let me try that out. Let me see what the steel palette looks like. Oh, you know what? We're going to have to put that on the... on something. Let's put that here. Put the steel palette up there.
Huh.
There you go. There's a steel palette. We don't even have to make our own. So you just need to make it where it fits on this one, where it's actually...
I don't think it can get that low.
Well, no, it can't get that low, but you can put the steel pallet on something and then have it get on there.
Yeah.
If it lines up. If it lines up with these two very, very small area, I don't know if it would. No, I think yours is just a little bit too wide for it. Let me get up there and see if I can put it on there. See if it will fit. It doesn't seem to want to. Doesn't want to come up that high.
Oh, come on.
What if you lower it?
Do what I want to.
Can you lower it?
Lower what?
The arms? Or is it not connected yet?
Why are the arms up? I didn't know it was on the ground.
There we go. Guys are ridiculous. What are you guys doing? Like a fork war or what?
I don't know what he's doing. I'm just... you were asking something about the...
The arms. I just wanted to put them down so I could see if they lined up with this thing or not. They don't really line up with it. And I can't, actually, you can't even lift up the pallet once it's on the ground, huh? Huh. It's kind of a strange pallet.
Well, you'd have to put the pallet... You'd have to...
Like, I can put it on blocks like that. But it doesn't, I don't think ours lines up with it. I know his might. His might be close enough. Yours might have to be one closer on the inside, which you could easily do just by adding one of those round corner pieces where it's connected. You know, do a round corner piece going inwards, another round corner piece going through the center.
Yeah.
And that would, you wouldn't have to change any of your design at all, and that would get you lined up with that one. But this is small, and the fact that you can't lift it up with the pallet is kind of...
What do you mean?
Oh, there we go. Oh, yeah, you can lift it. Let's see if you can get in there. Let me load. Nope. You might have to rearrange your thing so it's lined up straight with it. Which is another reason you might not want to use it, because you do have to line it up straight. It's very constricting in that regard. Can you get it in there? There you go. There you go. Let me lower it. Actually, let me get rid of my... Oh, well, it was lined up until you got bumped. Let me see if I can hit it with a hammer. Where's my hammer? There we go. Stay right there. Oh, crap.
Trying to slide it off.
Yeah, I hit it with a hammer too much.
It's all right. Making little doors over here.
Okay, that should be right there in front of you. Okay, so you're making doors. Now, how are you going to make the doors?
Just like that. Just put them down. And then use these.
The corner pieces again?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's see how this works. Don't get moved. Yeah, I can put you up on a... Let me lower it down a little bit. There you go.
All right, and then we come out.
Wait, what'd you just put down?
I'm just adding on to it. Onto these doors.
Oh, okay, so you're just filling it in the back. And that's the flat pieces, guys, that are in there. Let me show you what that looks like. Are you using the duck holder or the duck join?
It is the duck holder.
Okay. And you do know you have the long duck, right? Or the duck long?
No.
That one is...
Oh, I don't use that because it has a pattern on it that I don't like.
Oh, really?
These actually make it nice and slick and flat.
So does this
where
one?
Where that one...
Yeah, if you look behind you, it's right there.
Yeah, but put more than one together. I mean, yeah.
So it's all flat.
Yeah, that's true.
It's just a little longer. I mean, it's only two, and you're using three, so you'd still have to put one on the top anyways, just to kind of even it off.
Oh, I didn't want these. I didn't want them there.
It's all right. I'm just showing people what it would look like.
I deleted my motor.
Oh, you deleted your motor?
Yeah.
Oh, no, man. Oh, I'm sorry, dude.
It's all right.
We'll have to go back and look at the design you had on that one so that we could get it exactly the way you had it before. That's what happens when you have somebody here trolling you guys.
And now I need a button, which I'll put on the outside of this door.
Now, the button's going to be for the actual door that opens up, right?
Yeah, for both of the doors.
Now, the motor or the computer that you actually removed, was that the new one you were putting down for the door control? Or?
Yeah. Oh, okay. No, I meant my actual motor for the wheels, which will be easy to reset up. But, let me go ahead and... you know what I just did, right?
What?
I just made it so I can't access the controller.
Well, you could over here from this side if you want to, instead of getting rid of that.
No, I mean the actual controller that controls the doors.
You could put a small window in at the very top so you can get into there.
No.
No?
No.
Right. And while you're doing that, I'm going to look around and see if there's...
What world am I connecting to?
Anything else I can add to the top of this to make it look a little bit more... Oh, you know what you need inside there? So when you are driving around, you're not too hot. We need to put an AC unit in here.
Yeah, we can do that.
Wow, it is huge. That is a huge AC unit. Look at that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Definitely not going to go right there, but that's pretty massive. Maybe right there? It doesn't get in the way?
Where at?
In the front?
Where can you, we can do that, or we can actually
stick it
dig into the...
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we could do that right up here at the top. Let's see. It is a 1, 2, 3, 4, so it's 4. Let me go ahead and... That high... And that wide, I think. Let's see if we can get this right. And let's see if we can put that in there. Actually, no, it's a little smaller than that. And it goes back. Let's go back a little bit more on that one.
1 second. Don't put it down yet.
There you go. Let's get our concrete, or actually our steel back. Right there. Oh, no, that's not what I wanted to do.
Oh, take it off the lift for a second.
Oh, yeah.
After you put that down.
There you go. Not quite all the way. Is it getting stuck on something?
Oh, no. No, that's exactly where I wanted it. 75%.
Oh, so you don't want it to open up all the way then?
No. All it's for is, actually, don't even want it to open up that much.
And I guess we'll have to see why in the future to see if that, there you go. That's not too bad. That actually kind of blends in a little bit.
Actually, I might do a double jointed door. That way it doesn't take up so much space.
Now, this door is going to open up and be on the outside of the cab, right?
Which, you mean the door to get into the cab?
Yeah. Isn't that what you're making right there?
No, this is, that door right there is just to get into the controls.
Okay, okay. I see what you're saying. Why not make a little hatch that opens up or something like the wheels to, or not the wheels, but the door to like the DeLorean from Back to the Future? Instead of opening outwards, and that would take up more space, just have it open upwards where you actually have the space anyways. You know, like right here, just have it lift up from there.
I mean, like gullwing doors?
I don't know what that, like the DeLorean, you've seen that from Back to the Future where it slides up?
Yeah, those are gullwing doors.
Yeah, just create something like that where it slides up like those doors or just a hatch that literally opens up, you know, upwards instead of sideways. And that way you don't have to worry about it hitting anything over here on the side, including the doors to the actual machine to get inside of it. If you think that's better, I don't know. I mean, you can do whatever design you want on that one, actually. When it comes to this game, the sky's really the limit. Let me see. I'm going to go ahead and add a little bit more looks here. There we go. So now it looks even. And we got an AC unit in here, guys. We'll be able to turn that on and have a little bit of... wow. Did you do that?
Yeah, I was just moving it. It's in the rocks. That's why.
We'll be able to turn that on and have a little bit of AC in the summertime, guys, because you definitely need AC when you're moving around this kind of heavy stuff. Of course, it depends on where you live. I live in the south, and it gets hot, guys. It gets hot. So I would definitely agree with getting a little bit of cooling temperatures in there, especially because you're going to be hauling stuff, and it's kind of exhausting work, whether anybody believes it or not. When you're moving stuff around, you're getting in and out of your cab and stuff like that, that's, you know, it's going to take its toll on you eventually. So, yeah, take that extra little precaution and go with something that feels comfortable for you. Let's see. We're going to put that there again as well. Maybe going this way? Go over to the side? No, it actually will not go all the way over to the side. That's kind of interesting. So that one lines up, but when you turn it to go inwards, yep, doesn't quite want to do it that way. Let's see. Okay, we can get that in there. Will it fit? Yep, sure will. And we're going to have it where this thing is hauling, you know, chemical waste or something like that. Kind of looks like it already is. what can we put over here? Another one of those, maybe? I don't know. We don't want to put too many of the same thing. But these other ones are really, really big. Well, what about a valve? We can throw a valve on there. We don't have any valves yet. Let's see how big is the valve. Actually, it's not that big. What if we throw it over here on the side? If I throw it on the side, does it look like it goes to it? What if I throw it on it? No. That doesn't really look right either. I wish I could put it right there on that corner piece. Both? No. What we need is a middle piece that goes on this... Maybe down here? One right there, one right there? It's not too bad. I don't know if I like that, though. So what are you working on over here? You're doing the door that goes up?
Yep.
And so you put... where did you put the bearings? At the very top of it?
There's two of them, actually. I'm about done with it.
Okay,
so... I'm going to have to actually... I always forget to leave space for me to program it.
So you can see there's a bearing right there on that piece. And then there's another bearing on that piece right there. So it's going to open up both upwards and to the right?
It's going to open upwards and downwards at the same time.
Okay.
Let me go ahead and put a button down just to get it working. And then, let's see. So it's going to go... It's blue, and then... Blue.
Wow, so many lines in there. I do wish, you know, if you guys are watching out there and you have any say in how this game comes out, it would be nice to be able to change the color at will for the lines so that you can set things up and be like, okay, this is... I realize they're already kind of color-coded, but it'd be nice if you could do a little bit more in-depth than that, so that you can say, okay, the first computer is going to be green, the second computer controller is going to be purple, and keep going down, and different shades of that. Maybe just put one of those little color wheels in there so you can have different shades of the same thing. Because when you look at it like this way, it's very, very hard to see what's going on because there's so much purple in there. And yet those purple are going to two different controllers. So it'd be a little bit easier if you can kind of control that color yourself. Again, that's just one of those ease of use things. It's not going to make or break the game, but it definitely would make doing some of these really sophisticated projects. And this, again, is not really that sophisticated. Holy crap, dude, what'd you do?
The lift was on a rock. Let's go ahead and move it back over here.
Okay, let me put that down.
Oh, did you move it?
Yeah, there you go. I put it back over here where you want it.
All right, go ahead and take it off the lift. And then press the button.
Do it again?
1 second, let me go ahead and fill it in.
Okay, so it did lift up. How's it supposed to work, though? Oh, that's cool, man.
Let me put stuff down.
Okay, let me close it for you, then, so you can have it all going the same way. There you go. That is pretty cool. And you can see right there how he did that. Sorry. I'm hitting you all over the place. I'm just trying to get the good angle so people can see exactly how that was done. It's really, really difficult to show what was going on there. Okay, so you have one right there, and that's the angle that's going at. Blue on the left-hand side, red on the right-hand side. And then you have two right there, red on the left-hand side and blue on the right-hand side. So it's opposite on that one. And then as far as the controller goes, I'll have to show you that as soon as it's within sight right there. So 90 and 90 for the rotation on those. Is it trying to take off?
It is for the moment. There it goes.
Did you disconnect something?
It was, remember, the whole wheel situation happened where I disconnected the steering wheel and
you had to reconnect it? Stuff. Or is that
what you didn't reconnect that one thing.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay, so I like how you have to put the blocks down in a certain way for that to be a nice flat image when it comes down. So just remember, you want that that flat, solid piece in the front. You're going to have to rearrange those blocks a little bit or put them down when it's closed and then open it up after the fact. You know what you could do for these side pieces right here, instead of leaving them open like that, if you use the duct join, that one actually has three sides to it that has a flat piece. So that one could have the front flat as well as the side flat as well. It does have a little bit of a different look to it. It does have that little, X on the side of it. But I don't know. I think that might be okay on the side, don't you think?
For the what?
These side pieces. What is it? These side pieces over here. It's called a duct join. It's this one right here. You can see it has three side pieces. So if you turn it the right way, you can have the front piece solid and then the side piece over here solid as well. It just has an X on it. This is going to be the only difference. You see which one I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Like that one right there.
Actually,
I just don't want to put it down for you.
Stop.
Did you want me to leave that there? You're gonna have to move that a little bit because it's not facing forward.
Okay.
Let me see if I can get it the way you might want it. Like that? No.
All right. Make sure you're not attaching to the metal, though.
Oh, I think I am. Yeah, let me take that off. There you go. You got it. So it's a little different. You might actually change some of the other ones in there so that you can have like that little pattern going through it, like every other block or something. Oh, that didn't work.
It's too heavy.
Is it too heavy? I don't know. It's turning different.
I don't know what the problem is.
Oh, you know what it is? It can't go up because of these blocks here on the top. These blocks right here. When you tried raising it, it hits those. You see? And it's just not able to go up.
Okay.
So if you get rid of those. Now when you raise it. Yeah, see, there you go. So that works. Hmm. What are you going to do to fix that, though?
I'm going to keep this design. I don't mind having the X's on the side, to be honest.
Oh, the open side, you mean?
Yeah, I don't mind it, because we still have to put the shell on it.
Okay, so you're going to be able to see a little bit inside there, but, you know, that's not too bad. And if you cover that up eventually, because, I mean, we could always raise this AC unit up, and then you could cover this with a little ledge or something if you wanted to.
To be honest, I'm really not worried about it either, because we can do something where we start our shell at that level that I just put that block.
Okay, so you want to raise the AC up just slightly then?
Yeah, we can do that.
So let's try that real quick, guys. Get rid of the AC. Get rid of that block right there, and we'll put it up here. And then I'll need to put down one more block up here on the side. There we go. Why not do the exact same thing you have on... Nope, that's not. Because, you know, the right-hand side, this side over here, in fact, I can show you real quick when you hit it. Oh, I guess you really can't. I was going to say, the right-hand side over here, you have it where this thing goes up straight, and the little curved pieces pretty much block everything. Yeah, I don't really see any way you can fix that. See, put that in there. Right there. There we go. Kind of fits in there. It's not too bad. Okay, so what are you working on now?
That's it for that one.
Well, I think this is a good place to go ahead and end the episode then, guys. As you can see, it's a work in progress. Not completely done all the way yet. We still need to put on the door frames as well as the walls. Finish up a few of the details here. But it's coming along, and I think it's looking pretty good. I'll probably get rid of this little happy face. Let's just put that on there to kind of troll. But I like the back of it. I like the little pumps on there. I'm not really sold on the valves just yet. But it looks cool. I like it. I like it a lot, and I want to hear what you guys think. Also, I want to hear if you guys have any tips or tricks. Maybe you guys have been playing a little bit longer than we have, and you know a few solutions to some of the problems that we run into, or just you know, suggestions on how to improve not just the looks, but other things as well. So again, guys, thanks for watching. If you're watching on my channel, make sure to head on over to the Cypher Deck. Check out his channel as well. He does a lot of really cool Let's Plays, including Grow Home, one of the series that I'm watching myself and looking forward to seeing more of. You want to say anything before we head out?
I keep watching. We have more ideas in our heads. So we'll make stuff for you.
Until next time, guys.
This is Cypher Deck.
And I'm AC Gamer.
Peace out.